Right, thank you. Let me welcome members to the first meeting in 2015 in the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee and remind everyone to switch off mobile phones as they may affect the broadcasting system. Agenda item one, declaration of interests. I'm using this to invite our new members to declare relevant interests. We have Patricia Ferguson, who's replacing Cara Hilton, and Gil Patterson, who's replacing Fiona McLeod. And it would be appropriate at this stage to record the committee's thanks to Fiona and to Cara for their hard work as members of the committee. I'm sure that our new members will be equally hardworking, and if not, well. Patricia Ferguson, welcome you to the committee and invite you to declare any relevant interests.
I have no relevant interest to declare.
Thank you very much. And let me welcome Gil Patterson to the committee and invite him to declare any relevant interests.
No relevant interests. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That takes us neatly to agenda item two, which is for the committee to decide whether its consideration of its work programme and the written evidence received into our inquiry into elected conveners should be taken in private at future meetings. Do members agree to take these items in private at future meetings? We do. Thank you very much. Now, we come to item three, which is to discuss the membership of the cross-party group on video games technology. Members will see from paper number one that this group does not comply with section 6.4.1 of the Code of Conduct, as the group does not have an MSP member from the Conservative Party. At my request, the clerks contacted John Lamont, MSP, in his capacity as the business manager for the Conservative Party to ask whether there were any issues with the group's existence other than the volume of groups that the Conservative MSPs are already members of. John Lamont has confirmed that the Conservative Party would be happy for the group to exist without a Conservative Party member. The group has managed to secure a member from the Green Independent Group, and I invite members, do members have any comments on the paper that's before them? Right. I invite members to consider whether you're content to waive the requirement that a group's membership must include at least one MSP from each of the parties or groups represented in the Parliamentary Bureau on this occasion. Are we content? Right, thank you very much. That ends the public part of this meeting, and we now move into private session.